changing audience gets easily bored, they want to change their ways. Well, on this show today, we've got a new band from Glasgow called His Latest Flame, who will be stepping onto that tightrope. And we've got an old hand who's suffered a hail of abuse and has survived to tell the tales. But first, the video of Mr. Pete Burns of Dead or Alive. Now, they keep on writing you off, but you keep on coming back. You're more popular now than ever. Do you ever listen to what they say about you?
No, not at all.
Yeah? I mean, like, at the moment, you're huge in Japan, aren't you?
Yeah.
Like, what kind of amount of... You're playing a concert there in October. It's like millions.
We're going to be playing to audiences of around about 45,000, but I think that's mainly because Japanese people are big consumers of pop, particularly American pop, and America's where we've had 3 hit singles and 2 big albums. So really, in Japan, they don't think of us as an English group. It's more of an American thing.
And do you think of yourself as an English group?
Don't really think we belong anywhere. We don't seem to fit firmly into any category. I mean, on one hand, you do dance music and you're expected to be a very giveaway. Expected to be a very flamboyant pop personality, which is really not what I am.
Yeah, because you actually look like you should be a flamboyant pop personality, but you are quite a quiet, mischievous guy, aren't you?
Very quiet.
Yeah, what about the mischievous Pete?
Well, the mischief, but that comes outside of work, really. I have 2 different things. There's work and there's private life.
Yeah. I mean, that whole industry, Pete, after about 3 or 4 years in it, it sometimes puts about 25 years on people's faces. You seem to have survived that quite well. Do you keep yourself fit?
I keep myself very fit. I think in a job like this, as long as you're standing on 2 strong legs, you can usually face most things, really.
Yeah. I mean, what about the drink and the drugs, Pete? Do you keep clear of all that?
Not interested in it at all. I think for some people it might work very well, but I know that I'm too vain and too into self-preservation.
Yeah. I mean,
tabloid TV, isn't
it? Tabloid TV. Listen, we've got this wee thing going here. I dig into the archives at the BBC and pick out an old piece of music and try and relate it to the guest of the day, right? So I've picked this piece
of... You've
already
told me what it is.
I'm sorry, it's Sweet and it's Blockbuster.
Okay, very badly done, Richard.
You don't like it?
Well, anyway, I've got a new record out.
2 weeks running with their Blockbuster. It's got to be one of the largest selling records of the last 3 or 4 years. Here they come, Sweetie Pies.
Oh, you loved that, Pete, didn't you?
No.
No, oh, well, I'm sorry. Maybe I'll get it right next time.
Okay.
Now, those kind of bands didn't seem to take themselves particularly that seriously. You seem to take yourself, the whole thing, very seriously, Pete.
I take pop music quite seriously. All that we've ever wanted to do was make good pop records. So the fact that you get asked to do certain things in order to promote your pop record...
Like talk to me?
No, not talk to you. Like maybe get on an exercise bicycle or do things like that.
Right.
That's the side of it that I can't do because it just doesn't really gel with my personality. I really admire people that can do things like that. Because of my outward appearance, everyone expects me to be a particularly flamboyant person, and it's really a contradiction in terms.
Yeah. Do you not miss the old homeland? Do you not miss Liverpool at all?
I miss it for its sense of humour.
Yeah, because I still have a very Liverpudlian sense of humour, which a lot of people find quite offensive because it's a very warped humour. So now I've learned to quieten down my humour.
All right, good man. Thanks very much.
Okay.
From a big Scouse heartthrob to a bunch of girls from Glasgow who will have young men up and down the country throwing their boxer shorts on stage, his letters flame with Londonderry rods. Your love.